It's hard to imagine what life would be like without our ability to harness electricity, to light our buildings, and run our endless array of electrical-powered devices. In another segment, we saw what a simple circuit called a series circuit looks like. We saw that the more bulbs you add, the dimmer the bulbs, because the voltage is being shared across them. And if one went out, they all did. So how did we get to this? So many lights, all delivering equal amounts of voltage. And when one goes out, we simply replace it while the others continue to shine. The answer is an ingenious kind of circuit called a parallel circuit. It's a simple, logical solution to provide the basic wiring we need to supply electricity to our communities. A parallel circuit is a closed circuit in which the current divides into two or more paths before recombining to complete the circuit. Each resistor connected in a separate path receives the full circuit voltage. The total circuit current is equal to the sum of the individual branch currents. Let's build a parallel circuit so we can see just how it works. I've got everything we need here to create a parallel circuit. Bulbs, wires, and power supply. These batteries. Let's hook this up and then we'll analyze what's going on. I'll just connect this wire right here. And of course, the bulbs light up. Let's look more closely at what makes it a parallel circuit. See those wires running in parallel? The R's with the zigzags are resistors, an electrical component that limits or regulates the flow of electrical current in a circuit. In our case, it's the filaments in the bulbs. When the current moves through them, higher resistance in the filament wires makes them glow. In a parallel circuit, the current can flow down any of the branches and then recombine. The other thing to remember about parallel circuits is that the current is not necessarily the same throughout. The different branches can have different amounts of resistance, depending on how many resistors you have in the branch. Those with less resistance draw more current, and those with more draw less. That's because, logically enough, if there is less resistance to the flow of the charge, more charge will flow. And if there is more resistance, what happens? Less charge can get through in a given amount of time. You might remember that the voltage across a circuit can also be explained as the difference in potential from one end of the circuit to the other. No matter how many branches you add, the voltage will be the same across each. In a parallel circuit, a charge doesn't pass through every resistor. Instead, it passes along a single branch and then back to the battery. It doesn't matter whether the charge passes through resistor 1, resistor 2, or resistor 3. The voltage drop across the resistor in a single branch must equal the voltage of the battery. So each bulb experiences the full potential difference, V, supplied by the battery. This is very important because it means that we can add bulbs to the circuit and have them all light up with the same brightness as if there was only one bulb. In fact, no matter how many bulbs we add, as long as we have the same resistance and added one per parallel branch, they will be as bright as the original bulb. Do the bulbs look like they have the same brightness? They do, don't they? And that characteristic of electricity and circuitry lets us light up our world. But how does the voltage stay the same when there are more bulbs? If we call the potential difference created by the battery V, then all branches of the circuit must expend V volts. So each bulb experiences the full potential difference, V, supplied by the battery. When we're working with a parallel circuit, we can add up resistors to find the total or equivalent resistance of a circuit. Let's start with the simple case of two resistors, each 6 ohms on different parallel branches. Since the circuit offers two equal pathways for charge to flow through, only one half of the charge will pass through a given branch. While each individual branch offers 6 ohms of resistance to any charge that flows through it, only one half of all the charge will encounter the 6 ohm resistance. The presence of two 6 ohm resistors in parallel would be equivalent to having one 3 ohm resistor in the circuit. When working with parallel circuits, we can add resistors like this. 1 over the equivalent circuit resistance equals 1 over the first resistor's resistance, plus 1 over the second resistor's resistance, and so on, up through the last resistor. So for this circuit, 1 over the total resistance equals 1 over 6 ohms plus 1 over 6 ohms. That totals 3 ohms, and that's the total equivalent resistance of all the resistors in the circuit. So remember, the total resistance is less than any of the individual resistor values. That's always true in parallel circuits. Now that we know the total circuit resistance, we can figure out the overall circuit current using Ohm's law. Parallel circuits are great for things like car headlights, so that if one burns out, the other still shines. Or a lamp with several bulbs. If one burns out, the others stay lit. In fact, a lot of household wiring is parallel. Otherwise, if you turned your television or any other electrical device off, the rest of the electrical stuff in your home wouldn't work either. Why? Because you broke the circuit. Good thing we have parallel circuits, right? Now let's talk about another kind of circuit, the complex circuit, which is a combination of series and parallel circuits. In a series circuit, which we explained in another segment, the wiring simply goes in a loop. In parallel circuits, the wiring branches and splits. In a complex circuit, we have both. But how do we figure out what we need? This is called a V.I.R. chart, and it shows you how voltage, current, and resistors behave in circuits. We can use the chart to figure out how much current runs through a given resistor, the voltage across that resistor, or the equivalent resistance or current for the entire circuit. The V is voltage, I is for current, and R is resistance. Ohm's law tells us that voltage is equal to current times resistance for a given row that represents the value for a given resistor. So if we know 2 out of 3 variables, we can find the third. Let's figure out a sample complex circuit. This is a general example. Let's find the current through and voltage across each resistor. We have our speakers, a video monitor, a video player, and a gaming system in this diagram. Let's fill in what we know. We can put all of our resistors' values in the right-hand column. We know that our power source is 110 volts, so we can fill that in for the total voltage of the circuit at the bottom of the second column. Often, our first step in solving complex circuits is to find overall circuit resistance and then overall current. We do this by adding circuit resistors together until we are left with a single equivalent resistance for the whole circuit. Remember that when you add resistors, you must be aware of whether you are adding in series or parallel, since different addition rules apply to each. As we go, we'll see updated circuit diagrams that reflect the resistors we've combined. There are lots of approaches we can take to solve these problems. Let's begin where resistors are in parallel in a circuit. 1 over our equivalent resistance for our resistors in parallel equals 1 over our first resistor in parallel, 2 ohms, plus 1 over our second resistor in parallel, 15 ohms, plus 1 over our third resistor in parallel, 12 ohms. When we add the 3 resistors in the video branches, we get an equivalent resistance of 1.5 ohms. Now all we need to do is add these 3 resistors together in series. That will give us our total equivalent resistance for this circuit. Since the resistors are in series, we add them using our series addition rule and find that the total resistance in this circuit is 9.5 ohms. Now here's our complex circuit, simplified to a single equivalent resistance. Now that we know the equivalent resistance of the circuit, we can put that value into our V.I.R. chart. Since we know 2 out of the 3 variables, we can use Ohm's law to solve for the total current in the circuit. We can rearrange Ohm's law to solve for current. Current is equal to voltage divided by resistance. When we plug those values in, we find the total circuit current is 11.6 amps. Now let's go back to our V.I.R. chart and fill in what we found, which is total current. We can choose among several options to fill in the rest of the blanks. We just choose one and go with it. Let's figure out the current in each of the 5 circuit resistors. we'll use the fact that in a parallel circuit, the total current equals the sum of all of the currents through the resistors. And in a series circuit, total current is the same for all of the resistors in a circuit. Right away, we know the current running through the two 4-ohm resistors that are in series is 11.6 amps. So we put 11.6 amps as our current for those resistors in our chart. We now have two out of three variables, so we can find the voltage across each of those resistors. Using Ohm's law, we can find the voltage drop across each 4-ohm resistor. Voltage equals 11.6 amps times 4 ohms, so it comes out to 46.4 volts per 4-ohm resistor. Now, we'll put those values into our chart. Now, let's look at the relationship between the voltage in series and parallel circuits, which is similar to that of current, but it's flipped, like this. The total voltage in a series circuit equals the sum of all of the voltages through the resistors. In a parallel circuit, total voltage is the same for all resistors in parallel. Since each 4-ohm resistor has a voltage across them of 46.4 volts, this gives us a total voltage drop across those resistors in series of 92.8 volts. That means the total voltage drop over the entire parallel circuit branch is 110 volts, the total voltage of the circuit, minus 92.8 volts, the voltage drop across the two resistors in series, which gives us 17.2 volts. For the resistors in parallel, each one must use up the same voltage, 17.2 volts. We can now plug that value into our chart for the voltage across the 2-ohm, 15-ohm, and 12-ohm resistors. We now know two out of three variables in these rows, so we can solve for current again using Ohm's law. Let's rearrange the Ohm's law equation again, so current is equal to the voltage divided by resistance. And we find the current for our 2-ohm resistor is 17.2 volts divided by 2 ohms, which is 8.6 amps. For the 15-ohm resistor, it's 17.2 volts divided by 15 ohms, which is 1.2 amps. For the 12-ohm resistor, it's 17.2 volts divided by 12 ohms, or 1.4 amps. In this segment, we've looked at parallel and complex circuits, which we use for all kinds of applications in daily life. We also saw how to calculate current, resistance, and voltage, which we use to construct circuits that are safe and do what we need them to do. For more practice with circuit equations, check out The Closer Look. That's it for this segment of Physics in Motion. We'll see you next time.
For more practice problems, lab activities, and note-taking guides, check out the Physics in Motion Toolkit.